Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Azam Hussain, and I'm an environmental geoscientist currently working as an assistant professor at the Department of Biology, Geology, and Environmental Science. One of my research interests is to apply GIS and remote sensing technologies, or you can tell geospatial technologies, to study urban heat island impact. Now let's take a look at what we understand by urban heat island or UHI. And you can take a look at this nice chart developed by Lawrence Berkeley National Lab. And here you can see for a large urban area, the ambient temperature usually is significantly higher than the surrounding rural areas. And that cost higher, you know, that causes higher energy cost and brings up lots of environmental concerns. And here at UTC, I'm trying to develop a research framework to study urban heat island impact for the city of Chattanooga. Well, and I'm sure you are aware that Chattanooga is growing, and for the last 3 decades, the growth is significant. And you can see from this pair of imagery, the growth that we had from 1984 to 2016 is quite visible. Just take a look at this side. I just only focused on this one part of the areas. The growth is significant. It is more than double. All right, so now since the growth that continues, it is very important to understand why the Chattanooga is behaving like an urban heat island. And why we need that, and we'd like to make our development environmentally sustainable. And I designed this research to find out if Chattanooga behaves like an urban heat island. And if it does, we also want to find out what are the hot spots within the city. And how we're going to do that, we're going to use satellite-derived thermal imagery and ground measure temperatures. And here you can see a list of our observation satellites that is operated by NASA. We can get all the data that we need from them at free of cost. And here you can see we already have a framework developed by EPA on the study and urban heat island impact. And here you can see an image, thermal image that I recently acquired by myself and just was playing around to see how Chattanooga is behaving. So you can already see that the red area is indicating higher ground temperatures. It is already behaving like a heat island. But we need to process a large number of seasonal and historical images to confirm it. Right? And you can see that all the satellite data, as I mentioned earlier, we can get it from NASA at free of cost, starting from 1972. But we need a lot of ground data where I can involve students and I need support to fund them. Right? And I sincerely hope you find my research initiative interesting,